This is not a good day for South Carolina.
Cyber experts say a security breach at the Department of Revenue allowed a hacker to access the Social Security numbers and other private information found on nearly 4 million personal tax returns and 600,000 business returns. Hundreds of primary election candidates were forced off the ballot due to a filing error. Most of those who were allowed to return found themselves at a disadvantage.
Petition candidates very seldom succeed, and indeed write-in candidates pretty much the same.
The biggest thing I take from the campaign in South Carolina.
South Carolina ended its 30-year streak of choosing the eventual Republican nominee for president after Newt Gingrich won the state's presidential primary election. And while South Carolina won a challenge of its voter ID law, federal judges said it could not take effect until 2013.
You make principled votes based on the best interests of America going forward. And by doing so, you solidify your position where you can sleep well at night.
Lowcountry Republican Tim Scott became South Carolina's first black U.S. senator. He was chosen to take over the seat held by Jim DeMint, who resigned to become the president of a conservative think tank called the Heritage Foundation. And after months of talks that started in 2011, Amazon made it official. It planned to bring about 1,500 jobs to a new distribution center in Spartanburg County. Strangely enough, after all the hype, hardly anyone showed up at the job fair in September.
So this is just a wonderful day for me, a wonderful day for the Boeing family. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. This is history.
Excitement was there when Boeing rolled out the very first of its 787 Dreamliners made in South Carolina.
Anything at all, Mr. Wilson? Anything you want to say to investors?
Former Anderson County Councilman Ron Wilson was sent to prison for 19 and a half years. Prosecutors say he defrauded nearly 800 investors who thought they were buying silver of more than $57 million.
There were a limited search of his.
An apology about missing money was in a suicide letter by Tom Sponseller, director of the South Carolina Hospitality Association. One of his employees later pleaded guilty to stealing more than $480,000 from the association.
Lattimore.
The Gamecocks star running back Marcus Lattimore took a hard hit and dislocated his knee. While still recovering, he later decided to leave the team and enter the NFL draft. Cycling star George Hincapie admitted to using performance-enhancing drugs that he got from former teammate Lance Armstrong.
With me?
Absolutely.
There was a victory for upstate mom Lana Kirkendall, who finally made it home after battling flesh-eating bacteria shortly after giving birth to twins. And the birth of Kiko, the giraffe, put the national spotlight on the Greenville Zoo. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4.